Hi. Hi, loves. How you doing? Hi, good morning. Oh, I forgot the rainbow. There. What is up? I was like, what did I send you? Had me worried for a second, but I was like, I haven't said anything bad about Corey. You are amazing, yes. You're all amazing. Hi, Slotch. Hi, Jer Bear. Hi, Jose. Hi, Chris. Hi, Instructor. What's up, everybody? Happy Friday. How are you doing today? I know Corey is excited for the weekends because you work. But how's everyone else feeling? Hi, moderator. Wow, we're adding a hi in front of it now, making it more friendly. When you said like streamer, it's like a cowboy in a bar as somebody comes in, you know, streamer. How am I doing? The same. Tired as always. Not as bad as yesterday, I think. You're evolving. Not as bad as yesterday, but still. I'm drinking a smoothie for breakfast, and it's very earthy tasting because I didn't put enough like sugary fruits in it. It's a greens powder. Cause I don't like the vanilla. Oh. What the hell just happened? I just turned off the monitor on accident. What's it called? I don't like the vanilla and the chocolate flavors cause they taste like chemicals. From like other companies. So I got this one, but it is very, it's like you can tell it's made with like real stuff, but the price for that is that it tastes earthy and like not like sugar, not like chemical sugar, you know? Hi, Prax. So yeah. No, I'm talking about the protein powder that I'm using currently. Mm-hmm. Hola. No, the vegan ice cream that I got is very sugary. I need to not eat it every day. But they're literally, this is the size of the ice cream cone. No, maybe even small. No, this is the size of the ice cream cone. Look how tiny it is. And this is like the ice cream part right here. And then this is the cone. It's the tiniest little ice cream ever. It's coconut milk ice cream. So I'm like, I can have one a day. The serving size is 6. Hi, it's nice to see you too. Let's look at the nutritional value. It's 370 calories for 6 cones. 29 grams of sugar for 6 cones. So if you divide that, it's 4.8 grams of sugar for 1 little cone. That's nothing. Right? It is. It's dairy-free ice cream. No, it's made from coconut milk, water, sugar, cocoa, semi-sweet chocolate, cocoa butter, pea protein isolate, and then a bunch of other stuff. Maybe it's something else that's causing the issue. Maybe. Let me see what else they have in there. Like maybe the cone. Because it's made of, you know, it's like gluten. I don't know. But unbleached wheat flour, sugar, coconut oil, soy lecithin, salt, caramelized sugar syrup. And then there's chocolate in the base of it also. I don't know. Nothing here seems too bad. Like the gums maybe, but there's gums. There's like a lot of like gums and a lot of things. So I don't know. What do I want to sing? We allow it. It's over and done. You guys putting songs in there? Oh, oh. Sing to start with, though. Some Sheryl Crow. And where are you now? Now that I need you. Tears on my pillow, wherever you go. Cry me a river. That leads to your oceans. You'll never see me fall apart. Oh. All right, now I have to adjust. I took the nails off last night. Now it's just my regular nails that I painted. So I don't have my long nails to pick the strings right now.
Gotta feel like hell tonight. Tears of rage I cannot fight. Strong enough to be my man, my man. Nothing's true and nothing's right, so let me be alone tonight. 'Cause you can't change the way I am. Strong enough to be my man. Don't leave. I'm throwing punches in the air. When I'm broken down and I can't stand, you be man enough to be my man. Lie to me, I promise.
He can't bench me. Maybe he can. I don't know. I is trying up to be my man. Messed up the timing at one point in there. Threw me off, but... But it's okay. Baby, yeah, it's okay. Hi. How you doing? Mr. Papanopoulos, hello. Nappy, thanks so much for the follow. I need to, like, finish this. Are you trying to request the Justin Bieber song? I know that one. Let me see. Sometimes when I'm feeling nice, I just add the song to the list. What do you mean? Jenning, are you doing? I know, some days I'm not feeling as nice. Always professional. You're a little bit of a sand panda today? Oh no, why? The day is never Friday. Really? I'm always nice on Fridays? You're just feeling like down in the dumps today. I have days like that.
of time to think it through. And maybe I'm too good for you. Oh, do you believe in life after love?
Definitely not drone. Welcome. Hi, Sam. I wonder if that person, that Corey fake band that got really mad about being fake band, I wonder if they went to like another stream after and they were like, I was just treated so rudely in this other stream. I wonder if they went and like complained somewhere else. I also wonder how it went for them in, like, other streams, because I feel like in terms of, like, making fun of people, like, it's pretty mild here. Da-na-na-na. It's mostly just me getting made fun of, honestly. Like, me and, like, Corey. So, yeah. I wonder how it went for them in the Twitchverse. After being in here. Like, if you can't handle being trolled in a Kyger stream, of course you can, Tenning. Like, I don't know. I see what kind of place this stream is. They were so upset. I felt bad for a minute, and then I was like, wasn't really that big a deal. Like, the joke was so mild. It wasn't like we were making, like, yo mama jokes or anything. Like, it was literally just a fake ban. I did feel bad for a minute. I feel bad anytime someone's feelings are hurt. Like, hi, Sebes. Yeah, which, like, that's not what gaslighting is, but hi, Agonark. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what it was, Prax. And then it said, like, you know, exactly, that's been banned with the little face. They were new to Twitch, which, well, we didn't know that, but... Okay, no problem. but yeah, they could still talk in the chat, so they obviously didn't understand, like, how Bands worked. Shutta, thanks so much for the follow. But yeah, what do we do? Yo Mama jokes, they're not so much anymore in the U.S. A thing, but they were for a while. Hi, Pro. I don't do your mama jokes anymore because, like, that can backfire on you so easily. You know? Seven loves being banned. For the gift, 3 months of subs to Shutta. Here in Germany, it's so common, particularly like 7-year-olds. I mean, yeah, that's who makes the jokes. Sebas, please let me know if there's something that I can sing for you. Geiger Santana. Stop the looting, stop the shooting, pickpocketing on the corner. See as the rich is getting richer, the poor is getting poorer. So meet a Maria on the corner, thinking of ways to make it better. In my mailbox there's an eviction letter. Someone just said, see you later. Mama Chola, Mama Chola, ahora vengo, Mama Chola. Ahora vengo, Mama Chola, Mama Chola. Ahora vengo, Mama Chola. Maria, Maria. She reminds me of West Side Story. Growing up in Spanish Harlem. Played by Geiger Santana. Wow, 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 wow. Se la favela, los colores, the streets are getting hotter. There's no water to put out the fire. Me canto la esperanza, se mira María on the corner, thinking of ways to make it better. Then I looked up in the sky, hoping days of paradise. Mama Chola, Mama Chola, ahora vengo, Mama Chola. Ahora vengo, Mama Chola, Mama Chola. Ahora vengo, Mama Chola. Maria, you know you're my lover. When the wind blows, I can feel you. Oh yeah, through the weather and even apart. Together, Maria, Maria. You remind me of West Side Story. Growing up in Spanish Harlem, living the life just like a movie.
Played by Geiger Santana. Wow, 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 wow.
Let's do a live learn so I can drink my smoothie. Oh yeah. Maria, Maria. That song that I posted in song suggestions. A 4 minute wow wow. Oh my gosh. I can skip it. Well, maybe I'll do some of it. Some of it. Oh, that's even easier if it's at the end. Why isn't this playing? Oh, it's playing for you guys, right? Hold on. How do I fix this? Oh, it's not playing anything for you? Wait, hold on. Let me know if you guys hear something, okay? Give me 1 second. Do you guys hear something right now? No? Okay. Perfect. That's how it's supposed to be. No. I was worried that you would be hearing something. Paige Turner streamed last night, and sometimes he changes the audio settings, but he usually changes them back. So I was like, oh, maybe he didn't change this one thing. Yeah, he streamed last night. Weren't you there? He streamed at night. Like at 9 p.m. or something? I know, he streams very late. I'm usually just like in bed, like half falling asleep.
Footprints and the sand. Cold walk in December. I'm in a bye league.
Hi Matt, welcome. I am a terrible Madia. Mm-hmm. What I was obsessed with. Thanks, League. My smoothie's fine. I didn't put enough, like, sugar in it. It's also like a lot. I do. It's true. We should have it. We should just do auto mod. That would be funny. If it just auto mod, like, doesn't let people say granny. I don't mess with the girl I was obsessed with. I have mod status in like so many streams. I'm a really bad mod. Thanks, Matt. They're excited about my voice, man. Have you ever been made with mod without being asked first? Yeah, I'm like honorary mod in a lot of like other streamers' channels, but it's like friendship modding. You know? Hi, Photoelectric, how you doing? I don't mess with. It probably would be funny with like the commentary. You'd be like, oh hell no. Smoothie is like hard to drink because it's so much. The stock guy, hello. Run ads? What? You want me to run ads? Monetize us? Okay. Damn it. They're going too fast. You like ads? Okay. Now half of them can't see me anyway. Oh gosh. I've never seen so much hype for ads in my life. Okay, photo luxury. All right, let me sing a song for y'all. I'm learning one right now, but I'll come back to it. I ran an ad. It's running right now. I ran a minute 31. I have to wait. I can't run in one right after this, though. There's like a cap. Sorry. My. Tenning, thank you so much for the 10 gift subs. Woo! IH saying thanks so much for the bits as well. Mighty Warlock, thank you so much for the sub. Kid Wait, thank you so much for the 5 gift subs. Woo! Please let me know what I can sing for y'all. Ay, ay, ay. How are y'all doing? Welcome. What's up, you guys? The smoothie's making me, like, super cold. It's using music to reach non-musical goals. You have to be a board-certified, licensed music therapist. Market reversed, we're saved. Okay. Kalix, my week has been good. It's been a bit of a roller coaster. What about you? Thanks y'all so much for the follows and welcome. I think it's MT. Yeah. I did run an ad. Make those buttons. I'll run another one in a minute. And then that'll be it, because I don't wanna overdo it, you know. What's y'all's obsessions with ads? Man's way of donating. All right. But I don't want my regular viewers to miss out on the music that they came for. This is gonna be the last one.
Red leaves on the river, footprints in the sand, cold walk in December, warming up your hands, sundress on the front step. Sun up by the lake, lay down in the backyard, lying wide awake. Some memory I don't mess with. Girl, I was the best with. One I was obsessed with. Girl, you just don't get it. I'd fall right back with one slip. Always leaves me helpless. Hate me, I can't help it. Gotta leave us where we left it. Thank you. walk in December, warming up your hands.
I'm at the top. JSK, do you not follow a lot of people? Hi, y'all. Welcome. I hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a good day. not many big ones. Thanks, Kid Wait. Can you use your music therapy to turn the market around? I mean, maybe. Should I go to, like, the New York Stock Exchange and just go, like, sit there and sing to them? Maybe that would help. You're welcome, Tenning. Yes, please. All right, somebody's got to buy me a ticket to New York first because I'm not going to pay for that. Da-da-da, da-da. They'd at least be happy while they trade. Yeah, probably. My friends, what did everybody have for breakfast this morning? Mm-hmm. Are you saying breakfast like a question mark because you don't eat breakfast? Chicken sandwich sounds like a really good breakfast. I want like a biscuit chicken sandwich. Oh. Bagel and Spam. Ooh. That's interesting. Oh, wow. Coffee. Y'all are so silly. You can't just have coffee for breakfast. Peanut butter. Just spoonfuls of peanut butter. Egg toast and fruit is good. Tea and buns. Burger with falafel. Burger for breakfast? Okay. Did it have like a fried egg on it? Your fourth coffee. Oh, y'all. Some of you need to eat. Snow glows white on the mountain tonight. Not a footprint to be seen. Kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like... Hold on. My throat is really cold from the smoothie. I need to stop drinking it. I mean, you can do like... Why don't you do delivery, though? If you don't want to cook for yourself. It is ironic because I'm singing a song about being cold. Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this whirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in. Heaven knows I've tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you'll always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Turn away and slam the door. I don't
never bother me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small, and the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Let it go.
My least trolliest mod is here. Let it go. There's a slot available if anybody wants to fill it. Thanks so much for the follows, y'all. I really appreciate it. Hope you're doing well. You know how you're supposed to like warm up before you sing? I did like the opposite. Da 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 da. I'm freezing. Let it go, let it go. We have 69.6 viewers. I do know Wonderwall. The opposite of warming up to sing is drinking a smoothie while you're singing. It's like the silliest thing you can do. Yeah. How y'all doing though? I play all kinds. The only thing that I don't have on my list is probably like heavy metal and like heavy rap. But I have rock, country, pop, R&B, folk, like disco. I don't know, all kinds of stuff. If you look at my list, I have 923 songs, something like that. I think I have an Eric Clapton song. I don't think I have a BB King song though. Hi Elisa! You showed up for 696? Any opera? I don't think I have any opera. I think the list is closed. Hold on. Let me open it back up.
Deo, me say deo. Daylight come and me wanna go home. Deo, me say deo.
That one? I don't have that one on my list, but it's a cute song. Hola, Lino. I feel a sneeze coming. What are y'all's plans for the weekends? Sobrina means niece. Cute.
What do you mean? Oh, when you nod your head yes, but you wanna say no, what do you mean? Yeah, yeah, when you want me to move, but you tell me to go, what do you mean? Oh, what do you mean?
You know what I just realized? I don't remember how some of the song goes. I'm gonna listen to it really quick. Watch your investments crash around you. Why? Hola, Matias. Si hablo español. Pueden hablar en español si hablan en español. Hi, Turfy.
When you nod your head, yes. But you wanna say no, what do you mean?
Welcome, Chibi Witchy. I like your name.
But you tell me to go, what do you mean? Oh, what do you mean?
A random stranger told you that?
Better make up your mind, what do you mean? You're so indecisive.
The song is so old, like I don't remember. I do have Bob Marley on my list, yes. See? Thanks, General. Hmm? I mean, it's not like that old, but it's... whatever. Hold on, let me blow my nose. What amp you got? It's actually plugged into a looper station, a loop station, and it's using the amp from that. I don't know. I just plugged it in one day and I was like, ooh, it amplifies to the guitar. And then we just left it plugged in. This is a Fender Stratocaster.
What do you mean? Whoa, when you nod your head, yeah. But you wanna say no, what do you mean? Yeah, yeah, you don't want me to move. But you tell me to go, what do you mean? Oh, what do you mean? Say we're running out of time, what do you mean? Yeah, yeah, what do you mean? Better make up your mind, what do you mean? You're so indecisive, what I'm saying. Trying to catch the beat, make up your heart. Don't know if you're happy or complaining. Don't want to fit in, but where I start. First you wanna go left, and you wanna turn right. Wanna argue all day, make love all night. Up and you're down and then in between. Oh, I really wanna know, what do you mean? Yeah, yeah, when you nod your head yes, but you wanna say no, what do you mean? Yeah, yeah, you don't want me to move, but you tell me to go. Out of time, what do you mean? Yeah, yeah, what do you mean? Better make up your mind, what do you mean? You're so overprotected when I'm leaving. Trying to compromise, but I can't win. You wanna make a point, but you keep preaching. You had me from the start, won't let this in. First you wanna go left, argue all day, make love all night. First you're up and you're down and between. Oh, I really wanna know, what do you mean? Whoa, when you nod your head yes, but you wanna say no. up your mind, what do you mean?
What does spot mean? Walking Wounded, thanks so much for the follow. Pudding, thanks so much for the sub. Woo! Elisa, thanks so much for the gift sub to Camo. And Cowfish, woo! Please let me know what I can sing for y'all. Okay, I still didn't remember parts of the song. Complaining. Don't want to twist and have to do a star. First you want to go to the left, then you want to turn right. What song were you thinking, Pudding? Yes, I do need to drink some water, it's true. What do you mean? I don't know this one, but in my Discord you can put it in the song suggestions, and then in the meantime you can request something that is from my list. Because this is how you do a live learn. Did you end up singing for them the other night, Elisa? She didn't. Wow, how rude. Did she use me as an excuse because I left? You did sing? I'm craving like a really specific pizza right now. I'm craving like that pizza that you get at one of those like small Italian plate, like small Italian restaurants. You know, the ones that have like the red and white checkered tablecloths. Like one of those. You mean a good one? Yeah. That's like the type of I'm craving like family style pastas and salads and like that like thick pizza. And then after you eat it, you actually don't feel good because they put so much cheese on it, but in the moment it tastes good. Yuzu, thanks for the follow. And Hawkeye and Mabo and Walking Wounded, thank you so much. Like the environment than I am the actual pizza. But I'm also craving pizza a little bit. Closing time. Open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time. Turn all of the lights on, every boy and every girl.
seconds, move it to the exits. I hope you have found a friend. Closing time, every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end. Yeah, I know who I want to take me home. I know. Every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end.
Servilla and Nerguna, thanks so much for the follows. Brian, thanks so much for the follow. Hayden, thanks so much for the 5 months. Ooh, please let me know if there's something I can sing for you. I play the electric guitar instead of the acoustic because the acoustic is a lot bulkier and it means that my arms have to be higher up like this, and then I get a ton of back pain from it. Eventually, I will get a small acoustic electric guitar, but right now it's not really like a priority since I already have something that works. I thought you were saying die, and I was like, Lino, what the hell? Lucky can take you home. Aww. Right? It looked like die, Jennifer, die. I'm like, oh my god. This was in B. I put a capo on 4 and played it in the original key. Acoustic guitars kill. Acoustic guitars just hurt me because I'm small. I'm a small person. So... I would never say that Corey would ban me. Yeah, I'm small. Thanks, Cool Killer. Closing time reminds me of being in like one of those like small bars where everybody knows everybody and like it's in, like in a small town. Because this is like gather up your jackets, and it's like I would like never leave my jacket just like hangings in a bar here because like somebody would steal it probably. Hi Shadow. I'm 5'1". But you know what I mean, like I'm like you could only do that in like a small town where everybody knows each other and like they all go to the same restaurants together and they run into each other all the time. I have dreams of living that life sometimes. I have dreams of living in like a really small town where everybody knows everybody. I feel like it'd be so nice. But like maybe I would get tired of there not being much to do. I don't know. Towns like that always have like events. I look very swole today. Yeah. I do. I live in Los Angeles. Yo, Bob, he stole my jacket the other night. Yeah. Exactly. I'd hate it. Well, I don't know. It's like very, I mean, those TV shows that I'm like, that I've watched that have like the really small towns definitely romanticize it. I did live in a small town. I lived in Keene, Texas. And it was a population of like 1,000 people, and you could drive through it in like 5 to 10 minutes. And everybody did know everybody, but there weren't any bars because it was a Seventh-day Adventist town. And everyone was a vegetarian that didn't drink. So it was a little bit different of an experience. Thanks, El Comanda. I have heard that before. Well, I did live in a small town, but I feel like it would have been nice if it had like bars. And like all it had was a Sonic. That was the only restaurant that the town had. You had to drive outside the town to go to a restaurant that wasn't Sonic. I mean, you could eat meat, but you had to leave the town to go to a grocery store that sold meat. So, 890K? Yeah, I think so. You grew up in a bar? Oh gosh, I don't know. Maybe I wouldn't love that, Elisa. Everyone would know your business. I know, but like, my family, we're very gossipy. We're a very gossipy family. So I feel like that wouldn't even be like weird for me. That would be like fun. 4,000. Y'all, I lived in a town of 1,000 people. I mean, that's small. I feel like I could do it. I survived there. Town that I lived in. I don't think there was a middle school. No. My senior class was 20 people. Do you have any tricks for keeping a healthy singing voice other than smoothies. Warm up before you sing. Don't drink anything cold. Don't drink anything super hot. And what else? Do like breathing exercises, like make sure your lungs are strong. Working out can definitely help. If your throat hurts, don't sing, don't force it. Yeah, I'm telling you all the things that I don't do, except for the workout. I do work out. Hi, Meaty. How you doing? Don't do as I... Wait, say as I do, not as... Wait. Do as I say, not as I do. I think that's how it goes. Yeah, that. I do sing. What are you talking about? Everybody in my small town also went to the same high school, and it wasn't even a public school. It was a private school. I don't think there even was a public school in the town. Yeah, there wasn't. Actually, maybe there wasn't even an elementary school. There was a private college in the town. It was a private Seventh-day Adventist college and a private Seventh-day Adventist high school. This is too high, I think. Yes. I'm so cold. Depends on your viewpoints on... It depends on your views on religion, yeah.
Don't waste your time on me. You're already the voice inside
Wait, who actually saw people fighting each other in high school? I feel like that's just in the TV shows. I had my main school that I went to, because that was only a semester that I went, that I lived in that small town. But when in my regular high school, like public school in San Antonio, I never saw anybody fight. Really? Like prison, Javier? Like physically fight each other? You saw someone get stabbed in high school? Oh my gosh. I'm trying to remember like my class size for... I feel like we've talked about this before too. A plaster shaving tool from art class? Oh my gosh. It had 3,517 students. I guess that's still not that much, huh? Hi, Voyager. I'm not talking about your gentleman's club. I'm talking about high school. So that mine had 3,500. Actually, I think it was closer to 5,000 when I went there. Full-on brawls and multiple teachers and security guards would have to break up. Girls would accidentally push each other downstairs over a boy. Well, that's not accidental. Oh, my God, you guys. Wow. My high school did not have that. At least I never saw it. Da-na-na-na. That's so weird. It's very weird. I don't know. Small Jenny never saw it. The view was blocked. Oh gosh. Like I know I personally never fought anybody over anything. And I never saw that. I thought I was a mean... You thought I was a mean girl? What? Me? Me? No, I was the type of person trying to be friends with like every single friend group at the school. That was the largest in the state. Now high schools in the area are pushing 5K. The school that I went to apparently is at 3,500. And I think it was higher than that when I was there. I was the needy girl. I'm not needy. I wanted everybody to be friends. Like, I wanted everybody to love everybody. And, like, get along. So I would, like... I would befriend, like, one or two people from each friend group. And I do remember, like, there were times... Like, especially with, like... Like the goth kids or like the cat ear kids, like they would definitely look at me and be like, what's this girl doing here? But eventually they would just realize that like I wasn't gonna judge them for anything. And that was nice. So they just let me be there. Yeah, you know, there was like always kids at school that would wear cat ears. I think they were like into anime and like, I don't know. I'm engaged, I'm married. No, there weren't always kids like that. Oh. Well, at my school there were. Like sometimes they'd wear like the cat tails also. Everybody was really nice, though. Even the like football players, like I remember watching on TV and movies and stuff, like the football, the jocks were mean, but the jocks at my school were really, really nice. Like some of them were in choir and some of them were in theater and some of them were like on the student council. Like everybody just meshed with everybody. I think maybe I was in a little bit of a naive bubble. You either have violence at your school or you have people with cat ears. That's it. No in between. They were afraid of me. Going in life that is, oh, you'd take cat ears. Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure fights happened and I just never saw them because I just wasn't friends with those people, you know. Remember the day you kissed my lips, light as a feather, and it went just like this. No one's ever been better than the summer of 2002. Ooh, 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 ooh. We were only 11, but acting like grown-ups, like we are in the present. From plastic cups, singing love is forever and never. Well, I guess it was true. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Dancing on the hood in the middle of the woods of an old Mustang, where we sang songs with all our childhood friends, and it went like this: say, oops, I got 99 problems, singing bye bye bye. Hold up, if you wanna go and take a ride with me, better hit me, baby, one more time. Paint a picture for you and me, singing lies when we were young, singing at the top of both our lungs. Now we're under the covers. Fast forward to 18, we are more than just lovers. Yeah, we are all we need when we're holding each other. I'm taking back to 2002. Say, oops, I got 99 problems singing bye, bye, bye. Hold up, if you wanna go and take a ride with me, better hit me, baby, one more time. Paint a picture for you with me of the days when we were young, singing at the top of both our lungs on the day we fell in love. We sang songs with all our childhood friends. Oh, now I got 99 problems singing bye, bye, bye. Hold up, if you wanna go and take a ride with me, better hit me, baby, one more time. Paint a picture for you and me of the days when we were young, singing at the top of both our lungs on the day we fell in love. Y'all have me doubting now. I'm going to text my best friend and I'm going to ask her if there were ever fights. Do you ever remember there being physical fights between people in high school? Okay. Also, wait, there was something else. I didn't know how to play guitar when I was in high school. I knew how to play a little bit of guitar, but like not much. But I definitely was friends with people that were the people that would bring their guitars to school or like to parties and stuff. Hi, Barum. Oh wait, she answered so fast. Maybe once or twice. I don't remember that at all. Did I live in a little bubble? She's gonna say yes. I even went to like a lot of the parties that like the football players would throw, and I would go to the parties that like the stoner kids would throw, and I never remember there being any like fights at these parties. Hi, Nick Sounds. How you doing? Can we see a pic of you standing at your locker eyeing the... I'll send you guys photos in Discord of me in high school. I don't know. I think I have a really bad like long-term memory. Nobody wants to fight when they're stoned. Yeah, but a lot of them were drunk also. And I don't remember any drunk fights. But that could also be because I was drinking as well. So who knows? It's a big possibility. Woo! And I did sing. I started singing when I was 5. But I started singing part of the choir in middle school in 7th grade. Yeah. I started young. I used to throw parties in college, never had a fight break out, but once someone from out of town stabbed the beer pong table with a knife. What? I will say that it might just be like a privilege thing, because a lot of people would move to this specific district to be able to go to this high school, because it had like a high rating. So maybe that's like part of it too. Like maybe because a lot of people, like because of the, I was gonna say because of like the pressure, right? Like a lot of parents, a lot of like adults moving their children to certain areas and like giving up where they lived before for their kids. And so there was like a lot of pressure, like we moved you here, like don't mess anything up, you know? Bye, Slatch. But it was definitely like a privileged area. So piano is just whenever anybody asks for piano. Hi, Gooch. Did she say anything else, or she only answered that one thing? Mm-hmm. They're always a reason for kids to fight. Yeah, obviously. When teenagers fight, it's because they don't know how to... when adults fight physically, it's because they're dealing with crap they don't know how to deal with. They don't know how to communicate. Not enough therapy, you know? But it's like even worse for teens because... like you're in this weird in between being a child and being an adult, and you're being treated like a child, but then you're also being treated like an adult, and you're learning what responsibility is, and you've got like all this new pressure and hormones. True. Sweet pea, apple of my eye. Don't know when and I don't know why. You're the only reason I keep on coming home. Sweet pea, what's this all about? Don't get your way, all you do is fight.
fast and proud. You're the only reason I keep on coming home. I'm like the rock of Gibraltar. I always seem to falter and words just get in the way. Oh, I know I'm gonna crumble. I'm trying to stay humble, but I never think before I say. Sometimes I'm out of control. You're the only reason I keep on coming. You're the only reason I keep on coming. You're the only reason I keep on coming home.
Yeah, when I have kids, I want to put them in like something like that, taekwondo, jiu-jitsu, something where they learn, you know, like how to expend that energy in a productive way. You know, I told you guys, like, my parents bought me a punching bag when I was in high school because I was such an angry teenager. I was so angry at the world. So I would go into the garage and I would punch the bag and then cry. I know, right? Balloons. It didn't really solve anything, but it did help in those moments. I think I think it would have been better if it hadn't been every time I went to go punch it, which was like the whole purpose of it, like to go punch it when I was angry, my mom would be like, "That's so ugly." Because she couldn't even understand like why I needed to let out my aggression at all. Like anger was like a very taboo emotion in my house. It was like a very scary and like taboo emotion. Obviously, they like my parents have their own like, you know, upbringing and everything. Like the reason that they don't like anger. But it didn't really help as like a way for me to feel safe to like let out my anger in that way. And like now as an adult, like, you know, I have a therapist and she's like, if punching a pillow makes you feel better, like, that's fine. Who are you hurting? Even if you split open the pillow, nobody gets hurt. You know, you just go buy a new pillow. Baram, thanks for the follow. So, this is water. And this is a smoothie that I stopped drinking because I don't want to make my voice cold anymore. As long as Paige Turner's not sleeping on the pillow. Oh my gosh, yes. If I said I hated something too, yeah, I was like. So I have a lot of complicated feelings, like emotions tied to anger. A lot of guilt is tied to my anger. And so, yeah, and I think that just makes you more angry. Oh, yeah, I have family members that are punch the wall people. The pillow is just a soft surface that you can't hurt your hand on, and it won't hurt anything. You do too. Listen, my problems could be worse, right? But like, yeah. My feelings around... It is, it's therapy. My feelings around anger, my feelings around like lack of productivity. Those are the two things that I have like the biggest guilt about in life. Because I have like very limited energy. And Yeah, there's some days where I just can't be as productive as I want to be. Like, I try. I sit there and I try. And I'm, like, trying to... I'm, like, telling my... I'm, like, let's do this thing. Please, we have to do this thing. And then if I don't get things done, I feel so guilty. I feel like I've failed as a human. You know? Felt so good when we got to break boards. I bet. Your sister punches walls? That must hurt.
What are you talking about, Chuck Roast?
Yeah, I feel like the wall is not a good choice because you have to deal with it after. I feel like if I punched a wall and then if I was like fixing it after, I'd be like crying while fixing it. I'd be like, I did this. I'm a disaster. You punched a brick wall? Oh my God. That sounds horrible. I know, right? So I live in an apartment also, so I would never, Bro, don't be confessing to freaking crimes in here. Hi, Biru. Making me very angry, Marvin the Martian from Bugs Bunny. But yeah, anyway, if you want to punch a pillow, just punch the pillow. It's okay. Doesn't hurt anything, doesn't hurt anybody. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
So high.
I know this is TMI, but because I was drinking something cold and then I'm singing, which warms up the vocal cords and like the throat and everything, it causes you to have like a runny nose. Now you know. Now you know another reason not to drink cold things when you're singing. Ay, ay, ay. All right, more songs in the list available. Aw, you're welcome. Thanks, y'all, for your kind words, for your sweet compliments. Have y'all ever been eating soup while crying? It's like a very unique experience, I feel. And then the tears go into the soup, and you have little droplets of tears in the soup. 10 out of 10 would recommend. Yeah. Maybe one day if I'm lucky. It specifically has to be like a blended soup, right? Like a carrot soup or a tomato soup, like something that, you know, you can see the teardrops in, because if it's like a chicken soup, that's just broth and you can't see the tears. And then I'm so high. Yeah, it has to be a thick soup. I was just thinking about all the silly ways I express my emotions. Jojo and Driowin and Lil Siri Vert, thanks so much for the follows. I don't do that often, but it's happened. Okay. La 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 la. Good soup. Shinzo, thank you for the gift sub to Michael. Woo! Tears of joy, oddly specific. Okay. I know you guys have gone through this one. Are you ever crying about something and then you look in the mirror and then you're like, like kind of cry laughing because you're looking at yourself in the mirror and you're like, oh my god, I'm being so dramatic right now? Context, like, I cry a lot. I'm like a very easy crier. I cry about like those like Father's Day commercials where like they give the dad a truck that the dad always wanted. Like, why do I care if he got the truck that he wanted? But I'm sitting there like crying every morning when I wake up. No, I try not to look at myself in the mirror as a rule. You laugh at how ugly I look when I cry. I'm not a pretty crier either. I look like. You rarely cry on stream. Yes. I'm going to tell you why. Or my theory why. I grew up performing, right, since the age of 5. And a big thing for performing, which I still make faces and stuff, which I never would have done when I was performing growing up. But I was always told, like, you know, it's like acting. You have to, when you're performing, you have to like make sure you don't let your like emotions interrupt your performance. I've cried, I think, 2 or 3 times in the last 4 years on stream. Care what truck he's getting. I cried on a TikTok this morning, then had to repost. Wait, you were crying on the TikTok, or you watched a TikTok that made you cry that you reposted? Oh my gosh, I just started Peacemaker. I get that reference. The crying streams, or are they a surprise? A surprise? I mean, yeah, I don't ever predict when it's going to happen, but it's happened. Why Sway, hello. I cried once during singing Only Exception because everybody was being so nice. And yeah, I started crying like halfway into that song. That's the next YouTube sensation, co-crying, if you need someone to cry with. I would be surprised if that isn't already a thing, to be honest. Like, just videos of people crying. Wouldn't even be surprised at all.
We met on a rainy evening in the summertime. Don't think I need to tell you more. Needed a raise, I worked so hard for this love of mine. Love of mine. Still, I got nothing to shift for it. Here's a simplification of everything we're going through. Whoa, you plus me is bad news. You're a lovely creation, I like to think that I am too. My friends say I look better without you. Tongue-tied, twisted, whoa. Go on, baby, and go to my head. If I stay, it ain't gonna be easy. Okay, we'll do it your way. But this is the last time you hear the beautiful sound of love coming down. Love on the rocks. You love the chase, but hate me for the run around. Whoa, we're but just tired of the whole thing. You tell me what you need to know. You have to hide, and I just pretend I'm listening. I'm too tired this time. Old suits you wear and ties that won't bind, yeah. Hey, baby, believe me. If I stay, it ain't gonna be easy. Okay, we'll do it your way. But this is the last time you hear the beautiful sound of love coming down. Slow, cause it's so nice. Dulls my senses, drives my pain. But I do it again. Burns a bit to the touch. Dangerous if it's too much. If this bottle could talk, love on the rocks, oh yeah. Baby, believe me. If I stay, it ain't gonna do it your way. This is the last time you hear the beautiful sound of love coming down. Love on the rocks.
Love on the Rocks by Sarah Bareilles. You can actually see in the corner here if you ever have doubts. Aha, thanks so much for the follow. Hi Super Mario, how you doing? Okay, we'll do it your way. We have beef. I'm a vegetarian and I'm fucking scared of him.
Don't trust a hoe, never trust a hoe, don't trust a hoe, don't trust me.
Mm-hmm. On Nashville? I don't know if that song was on Nashville.
Don't trust me.
That song actually reminded me of when I was in college and I had a peer advisor, and she was a singer-songwriter, and she would go and do like shows, and I went to a bunch of her shows, and sometimes she would do Sarah Bareilles covers. She had like some of the cutest songs ever. It was like such a nice time. College was nice. I miss those days sometimes. Hiya, Booty. How you doing? The days I remember, yeah, there were some bad days. There were some bad days where, like, my roommates and I would all fight about things. Really stupid things, but... Am I the chavo? No, I'm the kiger. I'm the eye of the kiger.
Would you know my name? heaven, would it be the same if I saw you in heaven? I must be strong. I know I don't belong here in heaven.
Nacho, thanks for the follow. 6 grams is a lot, dude. You would classify this song as rock. I classify it as a ballad. Da, da. But I will tell you that if your audio is messing up, it's because you have to refresh the page, or if you have to, or you have to change like the latency or something. But why would that be difficult, General? I'd say like heavy metal is hard to play, but this kind of it's not. Da, 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 da. Why, Sway, thanks for the 11 months. Woo! Did you really eat 6 grams right now? Or, like, are you being silly? That's a lot. Na, 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 na. 1.5 pounds? You're talking about food ones. Right? Oh, I got you, General. Yeah, I was like, love portobello mushrooms? Like, what? Da 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 da. Just button mushrooms. Such a troll. All right, hold on. I don't know why my brain always buffers when I'm switching to piano. I'm like, what do I need to do? I have that one on my list, General. If you check out my song list, you'll see it. There we go. It's glitchy sometimes. This setup like works, but it has so many issues. It's not a candle. It's a Himalayan salt lamp. It's very heavy also. I don't have Nothing Else Matters on my list. Oh, I thought I did. I thought for some reason that I did. Maybe I sang it as a live learn one time for somebody. And that's why I thought I had it. The negative ions. Remember, Shauna? The negative ions. There's like people out there that are very angry about salt lamps. This piano moves so much. The queue is full right now, I think. like Himalayan salt lamps are a lie and they're actually bad for you because of the negative ions. And I'm like, I don't think this tiny thing that I turn on for 3 hours in the back of the room 4 times a week is like really gonna do anything. They say it was like a lie because, like, you know, Himalayan salt lamps are supposed to be like detoxing and like calming or whatever. I think it's calming. I don't have any delusions that this tiny little thing with a tiny amount of salt is going to be healing or like detoxifying. But like, I can have like a pretty thing in the back that looks pretty. I don't know. They got stressed out. Some people live for the fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power, yeah. Some people live just to play the game. Some people think that the physical things divine. What's within? I've been there before. That life's a bore, so full of the superficial. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if I ain't got you, baby. Some people want diamond rings, some just want everything. Everything means nothing if I ain't got you. Some people search for the fountain, promises forever young. Some people need it as a rose, yes, and that's the only way to prove you love them. Then me the world on a silver platter. Okay, I pictured a bell pepper first, too. I also pictured a bell pepper. I was like, oh, we're getting very creative. But then I was like, oh, black pepper, because salt and pepper, I get it now. Which actually, this reminds me, earlier somebody said that breakfast is a societal construct. And I was thinking about, like, who decided that, like, eggs are for breakfast? I love breakfast foods, but it's like, who? I feel like I remember being, like, on my own for the first time. And I remembered, and I realized that I could eat breakfast for dinner, and I could eat breakfast for lunch. I could eat breakfast foods, like, whenever. You grab the eggs from the coop in the morning. Oh. That makes sense. Mr. Dad, triangles and no ceilings, thanks for the follows. Thank you for having a very logical explanation for that, Trio Win. Makes sense. Hi, Pitbull girl. How you doing? You made it up? Well, I believed it. Because it sounds very logical. It was a marketing ploy. Well, that was my next thing. I was like, do you think it was Big Egg? Big Chicken? I'm allergic to black pepper. Like, when I... Not allergic, but I'm sensitive to it. Like, when I use something, when I put black pepper on something, I always sneeze. So if I had, like, a pepper lamp, then I would just be sneezing all the time. I'm doing well, Pitbull. How you doing? You kids and your conspiracy theories. Big egg, big chicken. I mean, are all foods a marketing ploy? I mean, people need to sell their foods, right? Like, farmers need to sell their foods. Especially things like convincing someone to eat the egg from a chicken's... The egg from a chicken. You're like, yeah, eat this thing that came out of a chicken, dude. Don't worry about it. Same with, like, milk. It's like, yeah, this is normal. You should drink this. I'm just saying. You know, kale, chard, really any lettuce. Why would people be convinced to eat that? You know, they have to make it delectable. Enticing. I mean, really eating any animal, right, has to be... I feel like you have to be like, come on. Really any food. Any food except for, like, fruit. I feel like fruit makes sense. You look at a fruit and you're like, that's pretty. And then you bite into it and you're like, oh, that's sweet. I like that. I'm gonna keep eating that. There was a time before supermarkets? Wow. I had no idea. I drink 2 to 3 gallons of milk a week. Oh my gosh, how? Listen, I'm not gonna pressure you into having children, but, like, you should have, like, 20 children. The fact that you don't have a lactose intolerance to dairy? To milk? Wow. Good for you. Seriously. Most people aren't lactose intolerant, really? To look up those statistics. I mean, nobody's ever asked me. There's never been some kind of survey that is like, are you lactose intolerant? Please be part of this survey. So, like, how do they know? Because they can't base it on people buying non-dairy products, because a lot of us with lactose intolerance still eat dairy products, and then a lot of people are like non-dairy, like choose to be non-dairy eaters, even without lactose intolerance. So okay, so I'm getting contradicting information here. 65% is a lot of people. I'm really distracted by the Costco emote. I'm sorry. Together again, my baby. Jesus would probably shop at like the kosher store. The kosher market. Yes, that's true. By, I think, a Seventh-day Adventist. I want to know how, like, why spam was created. Or, like, how. Like, what? How? What? Yeah, Shano, mine is, you know, I've got the Mexican, the Cuban, which they eat dairy, so you think I would be able to eat dairy. And then I've got everything else is European. Like Spanish, German, French, British. Is it my British side? Is that why I'm lactose intolerant? They just put meat in a can. What's spam made of? Let's see. It's made of pork with ham. What? Isn't that the same thing? Salt, water, potato starch, sugar, sodium nitrate. That's it. But like, it just doesn't look good. That's my issue with it is like the texture. Is it? I'm getting contradicting information here in the chat, which I'm not shocked by. Spooky Tortellini, thanks for the follow. Also, now I want tortellini. Oh my gosh. Funky ham. Ham that plays the bass. Spoiled funky. Yeah. I agree. I saw someone on TikTok that preserves their own food, and they preserve their own like meats, and I don't know if I trust exactly. I was literally about to say I don't trust myself enough to properly preserve meats. Yeah. Spiced ham. Oh. Like, good for them. Like, very happy for them. But yeah, I don't think I trust myself to preserve my own food. I did make pickled turnips, but I don't even know how long those are good for now that I opened the jar. And the jar was open to begin with. I never, like, sealed it. So, yeah, I don't know. Like, will I get, like, I pickled it with vinegar, which is supposed to kill the bacteria, but, like, how long is that good for? No, I didn't pickle by fermentation. I did a quick pickle. So how long does that last? Oh, it's good a long, long time. Oh, okay. I did a quickle. I still drop shells in my eggs from time to time. Same. I've had unpasteurized cheese. Good? Tasted good? I don't know. I guess not. If you run away. That's what happens when someone doesn't want to be a pastor anymore. I had a jar of pickles in the fridge for like 3 years probably, and then I was like, I don't know if these pickles are good anymore, and then I tossed them, but I probably could have eaten them. I have another jar of pickles in the fridge that's been there roughly the same amount of time. I just don't know. You, baby, my sugar boo, I'm levitating, the Milky Way, we're renegading, yeah, I got you, moonlight, you're my starlight, I need you all night, come on, dance with me, I'm levitating, you, moonlight, you're my starlight, I got you all night, come on, dance with me, I'm levitating. You're for me, I feel it in the energy, I see it written in the stars. We can go forever, now let's do it now and over, baby, nothing's ever, ever too far. Glitter in the sky, glitter in our eyes, shining just the way we are. I feel like we're forever every time we get together, but whatever, let's get lost on Mars. You want me, I want you, baby, my sugar boo, I'm levitating, the Milky Way, we're running it, yeah, I got you. I'm levitating. You could fly away with me tonight. You could fly away with me tonight. Baby, let me take you for a ride. Yeah. You could fly away with me tonight. You could fly away with me tonight. Baby, let me take you for a ride. Yeah. My love is like a rocket watching blast off. And I'm feeling so electric, that's awesome. And even to want to do, I can't stop. Watch it blast off. And I'm feeling so electric, that's awesome. And even if I wanted to, I can't stop. Yeah. You want me, I want you, baby, my sugar boo, I'm levitating, the Milky Way, we're renegading. I got you, moonlight, you're my starlight, I need you all night, come on, dance with me, I'm levitating. You, moonlight, you're my starlight. I need you all night. Come on, dance with me. I'm levitating. Y'all, if you're new here and you've been lurking or you've been hanging out or whatever, don't forget to follow the channel. You know? Follow it. And these are my socials if you want to follow any of those or join any of those as well. My VODs are always on YouTube afterwards. Please tell me the story about you getting lit at a bubble tea place. Yeah. I need you all night, you're mine. Let's look up how long pickles are good for. How long is a jar of opened pickles good for? 2 to 4 months. So probably a few years is not gonna be good. Fitu, thanks so much for the 2 months. Woo! I don't like when people follow me in the dark outside. But I like when they follow me on social medias and on Twitch. Here it says that pickles can be good for 2 years. 2 years. Yeah. Na, 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 na. Not dark mode streams. Dark mode streams are fine. Me? Oh, Fee too. No, I was talking about, we were talking about like, just like general kind of like life etiquette and, oh, I was telling a story about how somebody followed me into my parking garage. Were you here for that story? Na 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 na. The rules are complicated. So this is a while back, and I was just telling a story about how one time I was driving into my parking garage and this guy was trying to get into our building, and instead of like waiting, he followed me into the parking garage. And I was like, no. And so I sat in my car until he realized that you can't get into the building without a key, even from the parking garage, to keep people safe. So he exited, because there's a way to, there's like a door to go outside from the parking garage. Like, it's locked from the outside, but it's open from the inside. Anyway. So he left, and then I came out and I went into the lobby from the parking garage, and then I looked at him and he was outside waiting again at the front. And so I basically gave him a lecture about not following women into enclosed spaces. He was like, I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry. I was like, do you understand how dangerous it is? And how scary it is? And he was like, yeah, I wasn't thinking. I'm just really trying to go up to see my friend and they're not answering. And I was like, mm-hmm. And then we had to stand in the elevator together awkwardly. So that was the story. And then I was telling people that, like, if they're walking at night and they see, like, a woman by themselves, I mean, maybe even men also get scared for seeing, if they see other men and they're by themselves driving. I don't know. I mean, walking. Hi, Sid. But I was saying, like, if you're a dude and you're walking and you see, like, a woman walking, and it's dark, especially if it's dark. It could be any time, but especially if it's dark. Like, try to go around them, like, cross the street or, like, you know what I mean? Like, just there's, like, an etiquette to it. Like, don't speed up behind the person. Like, I've had dudes, like, walking behind me when it's dark and it's just us two. Saw it, thanks so much for the sub. When it's just us, like me and one, like me and a guy, and like they're like walking and they're like walking all fast, and I'm like, I'm about to be murdered. Yeah. Like, don't do that. Don't speed up. A friend of mine told me last night the reason for her watching the ID channel is to avoid danger situations. Is that correct? I mean, it definitely happened. We definitely tell each other, like, different stories and stuff. Like, I think one of the recent things has been people using Apple tags to stalk people. So that's kind of... But, like, your phone will notify you when you're near an Apple tag that isn't yours, if you have an iPhone, I think. Aw, thanks, Sots. Ginger, thanks so much for the follow. I really appreciate that. Thanks for being a loyal lurker. So yeah, always gotta be a little bit like on the defense, which sucks. We're ending stream right now anyway. That was our last song. Sots, next stream, please let me know if there's something I can sing for you and Fitu as well. I'm sorry. Okay. Putting this here. Aye. Y'all, thank you so much for being here. I love you so much. I'm so grateful for you friends and for our new friends as well. And I hope you guys have a wonderful weekend. And I hope you guys do something good for yourselves. You're kind to yourselves and you're kind to others. Being kind to others sometimes means not interacting with other people. You know what I mean? Like, if you're not in the mood to be nice, you know, just like stay away from people. So anyway, Valentine's Day is a sham, y'all. Don't feed into it, okay? Don't feed into it. It's a sham. It's a scam. It's a sham. It's designed to make you feel bad so that you try to find someone to buy stuff for. Just don't let them get to you, okay? All right. I love you. I'll see you guys again soon. Yes, buy stuff for yourself if you want to. Preferably after Valentine's Day when everything's discounted, but you do you, okay? I love y'all. See you. Bye.